Hello everybody, I wanted to talk to you today about using Wikipedia and using it in research. So, we know that a lot of people want us to stay away from using Wikipedia in research, but there is actually a way that we can use it and it can be very helpful. First of all, I want to point out that we can find some, get a good idea of background information. We can find general knowledge about things. And we can also find resources. So I'm going to show you. Let's imagine that I'm doing a some research on Martin Luther King Jr. So very easily I come up with quite a bit of information here, and it can help to give me some background information or general knowledge information that I might need in order to even start researching. But check this out. So let's see. I can see here Martin Luther King Jr., January 15th, 1929 to April 4th, 1968, was an American clergyman, activist, and prominent leader in the African American civil rights movement. He is best known for his role in the advancement of civil rights in the United States and around the world using nonviolent methods following the teachings of Mahatma Gandhi. King has become a national icon in the history of modern American liberalism. So far I'm learning something. But the great thing about Wikipedia, I think, is that say you're reading this, King has become a national icon in the history of modern American liberalism, and you're thinking, what the heck is modern American liberalism? Well, all these are obviously links, and I can click on them, and it will go to more information about modern liberalism in the United States. So I see here it says modern American liberalism is a form of liberalism developed from progressive ideals such as Theodore Roosevelt's new nationalism, blah, blah, blah. Well, what the heck is liberalism? I can click on that. And I can see that liberalism comes from the Latin liberalis. Liberalism is the belief in the importance of liberty and equal rights. Okay, that helps me out. So if liberalism is the belief in equal rights and liberty, then modern American liberalism must be belief in liberty and equal rights in America. So that must mean that Martin Luther King Jr. is a national icon for liberty and equal rights. That makes sense. So it's really nice that when you're reading something, you can actually learn what it is that you're reading about. So you can find some background info. You can find some information about general things like definitions. But as far as details and research and important facts, let's see what we can find out. Now, while we want to stay away from citing Wikipedia itself, we can see if Wikipedia provides us with any sources. These little numbers here, maybe you have used them, maybe you haven't. These are really going to help you out. Those are connected to the notes down at the bottom. So if you've never gone down to the bottom of a Wikipedia article, some of them can be really long, but there's some interesting stuff down at the bottom. At the very bottom, you've got some links to other lists that they're involved in. You've got external links, so it goes to different sites about Martin Luther King Jr. So this could be really helpful for my research. Get appearances on C-SPAN, some cool stuff. You've got further reading, so books, actual books. And if you click on these, sometimes it will go to, never mind. Just goes to what an ISBN number is. Okay, but so books, you could go to the library and check out some of these books and find information. References, so other kind of books that may have been used in the creation of this article, and then notes. These are what those little numbers up top are connected to. This is where people are citing the information that they have input into Wikipedia. So you look here, there's a whole bunch of citations because this is a long article, 223. But so when I look up here, someone actually cited the fact they wanted to put a place where there was proof that he was a prominent leader in the African American civil rights movement and a clergyman and activist. They supplied proof that he's a national icon of liberalism, and we can check these out. And what about if I want to use this fact that he was influenced by Mahatma Gandhi? What if I want to know who Mahatma Gandhi is? I can check it out here and learn more about him. But if I want proof, I want to check the source. I want to use that information that he was influenced by Mahatma Gandhi and the nonviolent methods. I can click on the number 2. It brings me down and highlights the actual source that they used. So this is the author's last name, De Souza. So Plácido de Souza, in January 20th, 2003, this is in the San Francisco Chronicle. So he published an article called Commemorating Martin Luther King Jr., Gandhi's Influence on King. And I can click on it, and it will take me to the San Francisco Chronicle article, and it will take me right to that source, where it actually talks about Gandhi's influence on Martin Luther King. So if that's some information that I wanted to use, I would use this source, the San Francisco Chronicle. This is a reliable source. Possibly. We would check it for credibility. But it is actually, it's published, it's a newspaper, it's probably more reliable. We can tell who wrote it. We can tell what their motivation was, but with Wikipedia, we don't really know. We can look up, but we don't really know everybody who's edited this and where they come from and their background. So we can find credible sources with Wikipedia.